since I started working on my Minecraft clone. My biggest ambition with it was to make it multiplayer, then add cool shaders, but I have already implemented this more or less. So now, my current ambition is to make it into a real game. You know, so you can enter it, create a new world, spawn with nothing in your inventory, and play some survival. And in this video, I'm going to add the most important missing pieces for the survival mode of this game. And I will also finally reveal my plans for turning this into a game of my own, so let's go. The first thing that I have to add to make the survival mode is a survival mode. No, seriously, there is only the creative mode right now. So I need to add a flag that tells if the player is in survivor or in creative mode. And the server will be the one to decide as usual if you are in survival or creative mode. And the main difference between mods is that if you are in creative mode, you don't consume blocks, whereas if you are in survival mode, you consume them. Another thing is like, you can insta mine blocks in creative mode, or you can also fly. And this reminds me that I should also add block breaking. Minecraft has quite a complicated equation to calculate the mining speed of a block. I didn't copy it one to one, but I took some inspiration from it. So one interesting thing that Minecraft does is that if you try to mine a block that you can't mine with the current tool, you get a big penalty. And this is good because it lets the player know that he is doing something wrong. So I just added the basic wooden tools for now to test that everything is working. And the code is simple. Tools can mine blocks and have some basic speed boost that is applied only if you can mine with that tool. I made it so that I can have tools like the pixel from Terraria that you can use for both wood and stone. But this is a spoiler for the end of the video. And you probably noticed that I finally added the hand motion, and I also hold the tool in my hand. This was not very fun to do. For every item texture, I needed to generate a mesh. In this case, I generated a front face, a back face, and also side faces to construct the full 3D geometry of the object. And before you ask, yes, it is also optimized. Let me give you a tip. To test things like this, you can create what is called a structured art. This is yet another trick that I learned from Handmade Hero. Basically, I place these colors in the corners to easily tell what corner I'm looking at when reading the texture's memory. I can easily tell if the texture is flipped by looking at the first color. And it was also useful to test if the final geometry is properly generated. And with the geometry generated, all I had to do was place it in the player's hand. Life was also something very important for the survival mode. I know it might sound easy to implement, but everything is hard to do in a multiplayer game. So the server notifies the player if he was damaged or healed, and the player simply updates the life. And I also added this nice animation when that happens. Then, if the player's life goes to zero, the server notifies the player that he died. Then, while the player is dead, it is just temporarily removed from the world simulation until the player notifies the server that he wants to respawn. Wait! Oh, come on. Okay, so I then also created a proper respawn point. And dying and respawning properly on the ground just feels, for some reason, very nice. It feels like the game is more complete now. Another important thing is hitting the enemies. So I just shoot a ray from the player, and if it intersects an enemy that can be hit, you can hit it. I used my data-oriented compile-time entity component system to do this. I know, a lot of words. You can watch this video if you are curious. But after a lot of work, I can finally hit entities. And the server can also notify you if an entity died, so the client can animate it locally. Before I tell you my future plans with this game, I made it so that you can have multiple worlds. And with all of this in place, this is how it looks to play the game. You might have noticed that I have some music for the game and sounds. Well, the next video is on sounds and music. And let's just say I have a big surprise for you waiting in that video. So subscribe to not miss it. And also, if you become a member of my channel, from now on you'll be able to see one Minecraft clone video in advance. So the next video is already out for members. Now you might be wondering, why not add all the other Minecraft tools? Well, I wanted to slowly start turning this into my own game. So I won't have the exact same tools as there are in Minecraft. I don't want to spoil everything from this video. So I will say this. This game will be a combination of Minecraft and Terraria. I will try to keep the best parts of both games. I always liked the exploration aspect of Minecraft, except that it is not rewarding at all, and after you travel for 1 hour straight to find a slightly different wood type, and no loot, you now have to go back. So I want my game to feel more like Terraria, where every time you travel, you find a lot of not only useful, but also mandatory loot for progression. And I will also add some teleport mechanics, or battle travel mechanics, so that it is not punishing to venture far away from your base. And weapons won't have durability, but you won't be able to craft them like you craft them in Minecraft either. You will need to explore and find some parts that you will be able to put together. There will be a ton of focus on combat in this game, and also weapon crafting, and each weapon will have its own fight style in a way that I haven't seen done before in other games. I won't give too much away in this video, so I'll just show you this photo for now, and I will reveal some more in the next video. So if you like this video, make sure you share it with someone else, because it helps me a lot. And don't forget that you can join my channel if you can't wait to see some more info about the game revealed now. See you!